how do you start that play for a development?
Man, I'm like this close to getting tired to people downplaying my athleticism at times in that locker room. I'm like this close. But on a serious note, I'm glad I could have those type of plays, at times to galvanize the group. Glad it went in. Good timing, you know. But I've been working on my body for the last year and a half, 2 years, especially recovering from that traumatic ankle injury that I had during the 2021 playoffs. I just felt like didn't have my feet underneath me in the last season. So coming into the season, I've definitely put an emphasis on just being more on my toes and being stronger at my foundational base. If you wanted to know the scientific aspect of that.
Kyrie, going off that you have to dunk, Nick and Dayron kind of don't know what to do with each other, then you motioned toward the bench and said something. Was that along the lines with what you said of the crap you've taken from them on it? You
I guess you could say that. Yeah, a little bit of stare down, a little bit of a surprise from those guys. It's funny making the young guys happy and smile like that when you surprise them a little bit, so look good.
I mean, just during this 12-game win streak, you guys had some attrition early in the season, Ben was coming back, during this 12-game win streak, you guys had most of the whole core together, whereas early in the season, Ben was coming back, et cetera. Just what have you guys been able to learn, especially, you, Kevin, and Ben, how you guys played off each other, and especially with Ben being the new guy of the three, that maybe you weren't able to learn early in the season because of all the other stuff?
Yeah, I mean, it's always great when you have a healthy team. We have that group in the locker room. When we build a continuity game to game, it has carryover, and we're showing that consistency right now, both ends of the floor. But I think one of the special traits of our group is the way we give each other space. We don't want to go ISO, and then we know we need a bucket to extend the lead or get back in the game. I think we're all locked in. Obviously, Royce not playing tonight. Other guys had to fill in. But that's been a telltale sign of our greatness of our team this year, is just being able to plug guys in, be wonderful with their minutes, be impactful, be intentional, and then we look at the results with them.
Did you see what Donovan did tonight?
I haven't seen it yet.
What did you see? What he ended up with?
What did he end up with?
71.
10 away from 81.
So that, and he broke your franchise record.
He said what?
He also broke your franchise record.
Good. Records are meant to be broken. I'm happy that he did. What's funny about it is, I don't know if I tell Don and I shouted him out, but I was on Call of Duty a little bit before the game with Don, and we were playing quads, and he was locked in, I could tell. He was locked in, I could tell. So
was he locked in the Call of Duty game?
We were locked into the Call of Duty game, but I had to get off early because I had to take a nap, and he had to get off early to take a nap. And you could just tell he was locked in. We had a brief conversation, you could just tell, little things like that.
Did you guys win?
No, I actually lagged out. I actually lagged out. My Wi-Fi was very trash, so I had to get off and get to my dad.
So, no dunk contest?
No dunk contest, man. Stop.
Just for the record. What do you make of the streak right now? That's 12 in a row and however many, 16 out of 17. What's been clicking more than anything for you?
Just staying present game to game and giving the game what it needs every day in terms of our preparation. Little things going, get our lifts in, days off, everybody showing up, little things like hanging out and just doing things for our camaraderie and our group goes a long way. So we're building trust on and off the floor, and it feels good. I don't think we really pay attention too much to the streak. We just really want to play well for one another. You can tell there's a special energy in the locker room, so we just want to take care of that. God, please just keep us healthy throughout the rest of the season.
Kind of to that camaraderie point, Jacques was talking pregame about what went into winning at a high level when he was playing with the Spurs, and he said guys enjoying being around each other, the camaraderie part. Where is that this year with this team?
Man, it's in a great place because obviously we can go outside and hang out. And then on the road, I think we all have understanding of what our lives are like when we're home. So when we're on the road, a lot of us have kids or we got things that we use to stay comfortable, especially getting in those four walls in the hotel room, we can get a little lonely. So we do everything we can to make sure we communicate. That's most important. Just have some fun playing a game that we love. Obviously, it could go either way in terms of people feeling a certain type of way about minutes, but we have a mature group in there emotionally, and the purpose is bigger than each one of us individually. So it feels good when you can have that selflessness in the locker room and just looks good on the court.